Hello and welcome to Proactive Investors. Here with me today from Arovella Therapeutics is Dr. Michael Baker. Michael, good to have you on the program. Thanks for being here.
Thanks for having me back, Alicia. It's good to be here.
Michael, it's been a little while since we last spoke. Can you give me a quick overview of what Arovella is currently up to?
Absolutely. So our core focus is working with our invariant natural killer T cell, or iNKT cell platform for short. Just to put that in context, we're the only company listed on the Australian Stock Exchange working on this type of platform, and one of a handful globally. And where we sit, it's currently a cell therapy. So that's really the cutting edge of cancer treatments today. And so to be in a differentiated niche section of the cell therapy space is quite exciting. But for us, the key thing is that we're developing this therapeutic platform. So because we think we can have a big impact on the lives of cancer patients.
Good to get some of that context there. Now, you recently presented to the American Association of Cancer Research, one of the most prestigious conferences for this kind of healthcare space. Can you bring us up to speed on what that was like?
Absolutely. And firstly, just let me point out, it was an honor to be selected. As you pointed out, it is a really prestigious event. So you have to submit an abstract and be selected to present there. So we're very delighted to have that happen. And when we did present, I mean, it was a 4-hour poster session where, I mean, we were essentially inundated with interest from academics, big pharma. So it was a really, really exciting step forward for the company, and good to put ourselves out there on that front. But really for us, that data was important because what it demonstrates is we've taken the product out of the academic setting. We've now modified it so that it's far more what we'd call clinic or commercial ready. And what we showed on that poster or that presentation was we can grow the cells, we can multiply them more than 5,000 times. When we do that, they still have the ability to find and kill cancer cells. And then when we put them into what we call a really aggressive leukemia model, we saw that they do continue to extend the lifespan of those mice in a statistically significant manner. So it's really exciting data. And of course, it was great to get the level of interest that we did from those that attended the conference.
Now, you did mention that you're one of the only companies in the world that is working on this kind of technology, but that certainly hasn't stopped you from collaborating with other ASX listers. For example, you're working with Imugene. Tell us about that partnership.
That's a really exciting partnership, and you know, I couldn't be more complimentary of Imugene and their platform. It's a wonderful company and a wonderful technology where they use a virus which essentially tags solid tumor cancer cells with a particular marker on their surface, and the marker that they end up on their surface is exactly what our iNKT cells will go after and find and destroy. So the idea is we take the two components and we actually use them together. So it's a really exciting proposition. We're delighted that earlier in the year we did get encouraging or very exciting data from the in vitro studies. And so what that means is we now move into animal models and so forth to confirm that and see how that data looks, which we're expecting to happen soon.
Now, most recently, you announced that you were closing down your R&D facility in Perth. And that was going to allow you to have some cost savings, but also prepare you to really go to the next steps with this therapy platform. Can you tell me a little bit more about what you see in the future?
Yeah, absolutely. So I think that's a good way to look at it, actually. Our core focus, as mentioned earlier, is taking our lead product, it's called Allo-101, and driving that through the manufacturing stages and into clinical trials. So I couldn't be more complimentary of the team in Western Australia that assisted with the shutdown of that facility. But what it means for us now moving forward is exactly that. We do have approximately $1.5 million cost savings from the historical expenditure of that operational or the facility operations. But more importantly, I think what it means is we now have a laser-like focus on our iNKT cell platform, which is incredibly beneficial and just means we don't have distractions as we look to take that into clinic.
And as you solidify this focus, it's important to consider some of the board changes and experts that you've brought in over the last 6 months. Who are the fresh faces on the Arovella team?
Definitely. And so we're delighted at the board level. We've brought in a new non-executive chairman, Dr. Tom Duthie. So he's a PhD, MBA, graduate and has a lot of experience as an analyst initially covering healthcare stocks, but in the corporate end of the equation as well, being involved in one of the largest, if not the largest, medtech acquisition in Australian history, and as well as a range of others. So he's got a terrific amount of experience on that front. So delighted to have him come in and take a really strong position at Arovella. And of course, we've also improved our operational capacity. We appointed a new COO earlier in the year, Dr. Nicole van der Veden, and also a new Associate Director of Project Management, Dr. Simon Poon. And lastly, we also strengthened our manufacturing capability by the appointment of Dr. Robson Dosser, who's he's got a great background in the manufacturing of cell therapies. In fact, he was at Kite Pharma, which is one of the more well-known cell therapy companies. So delighted to have him on board as well.
Plenty happening across the board over at Arovella, and we really look forward to hearing the next update from you and the team. Michael, thanks for your time.
Thanks very much, Alicia. Yeah, we're looking forward to a really strong 12 to 18 months. Appreciate it.